Hi, in this new grasshopper tutorial we will learn how to create this parametric structure. By the end of this exercise we will be able to control all the parameters. For example, we can control the height, we can control the bottom width, we can control also the start of this arc. We can also control the shape at the top, I mean the shape of the arc, the width of this part here. We can create something like this. We can control the number of arcades. And this thickness here, the offset distance of this top ceiling, and finally the thickness of the ceiling. Basically, all we need to do at the beginning to achieve all this, the main part, is to create half of this arcade here, this part, this half, and from there everything will become easier. So let's start from scratch. Okay, now we start by creating a vertical line, and we will use this STL line. The direction is the Z. And for the start, I will choose a point in the on the zero, and now for the length I will start with the 250 centimeter with two decimal. Now what I need to do is to get the end points, the start and the end of this line. So in curve, choose end points. I will use the start and the end to create two lines, bottom thickness and top thickness. So again, STL. I will create two. Start for the bottom, and the direction is the X direction. And for the length, I will start with 15 centimeters. I will hide the grid by pressing F7 so I can see the line. And for the top, also X, and the length I will choose 1 meter for now. Now what I need to do is to also to extract the endpoints of this line here, so I can build a vertical line from here that will create the width, the thickness of this structure. So again, endpoints. Also, another SDL line from the endpoint, Z direction. And for the length, to keep things parametrical, I will take the height of this vertical line, and I will use math here, subtract. And I will subtract 100 centimeters from it. And I will give it to length. This way, when I change the height, this line will go with it. It will preserve this 1 meter difference. Of course, you can change this if you like. So now, for this line, I want the endpoint, and I want the endpoint of this top line so I can create the arc. So, endpoint. Also, the endpoint here. Now I can create the arc. Now for the arc, I will go to primitive and choose by arc. Now, the starting point for this arc, I will choose the endpoint of this one, and the end is the endpoint is from here. Now I need also to provide start tangency and end tangency for. For the start tangency here, I will choose the Z vector, and I will choose the X vector for the end tangency. Now, what is the benefit of using this component here? The end tangency here, because I'm choosing the X, which is parallel to the X of the grid, this will ensure that when this arc reaches here, this point, at the last moment, the arc will be parallel to the X axis. This is helpful because when we create the mirror, since the part that is in the mirrored part will also start straight parallel to the X, we will not see a seam going from here to here. It will go smooth So now we have all the curves needed. So I will choose join curve component to join all these lines into one curve. So I will start with this one. We'll add it to the curves. The bottom line, press shift to add to this input here. Also this one. And this line. And finally the arc. I will choose the by arc output because it contains the whole arc. So now I can hide everything. Okay, now I will go to surface, boundary surfaces. This will create a face, a surface from closed curve. Now what I need to do is to mirror this surface. So I'll choose mirror. Now the mirror plane now is the YZ. So it is the YZ. Now the problem is that the origin of this plane is and the 000. So I need to keep this YZ plane, but I want to shift it. I want to move it, move its starting point, its origin to here. So to do that, I will create a YZ plane. And the origin of this YZ plane is the end point of this line here. And I will plug this YZ plane to plane. So now I have this. Finally, for this step, I will choose B-wrap join. Turn off everything. And now I have this component. So now we have a complete model. What is left now is to create an array in this direction, and then, you know, to complete the whole thing, and then add the ceilings and stuff like that. So I will keep this thing for another tutorial, the part two. I will try to finish it tomorrow, so I don't make this tutorial too long. And thank you for watching. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you soon. Thank you.